You guys, I wasn't gonna vlog today, but I have to because I have a massive, massive color correction in my chair and I'm so excited. And also I had to order Starbucks 3 times because they kept messing up my order, but they finally got it right. So let's get this day going.
That was so fast.
Hi.
Okay, so here's the color correction. So basically, this one looks like awful here, but if you kind of start going in between, you see we've got 3 bands, actually kind of like 4. We've got her new growth, then we've got some permanent color that I'm not sure why that was put there. Then we have like some random blonde areas and then orange brass. Then if I split it again, you can see that. So now we have, oops, excuse me, sir. band. And then we did a little test strand just to make sure that it'll lift, and we got a pretty nice lift, so that's good. I'm gonna go in and just try to really even out everything and do a bunch of low lights in between. So this will be fun. Okay, so kind of already started. This is the gist of it though. I've got some conditioner here, 20 ball right here. And I'm weaving, just breaking everything up. My main focus is this band right here. And then as you can see, all the different tones, so I'm gonna put some conditioner here because I don't want that blonde to get anything on it. And then right here, you see that needs to be lifted, so we're gonna put some lightener right on that. And so the thing with her foils is that every single one of them are gonna look so different. So I'm just kind of following where all those splotches are. A little bit more conditioner. Okay, so as I continue up her head, I am kind of doing this all throughout. So I'm just doing really tight weaves, trying to leave minimal fallout in between. And I'm trying to put the foil as close to the scalp as possible. And again, focusing on that dark permanent band that she has. That's my main area of concern. Then I'm just blending it up into the root. I'm not really worried about getting the root too light because I know it's going to lift. And I also don't want to create another band. So then I'm here, I'm grabbing the conditioner and putting conditioner on hair that's already super, super blonde. And then with my other brush, so purple brush is 20 ball. And I'm getting that on all the little splotches of orange bands that she has all throughout her hair. And yeah, I basically just did this exact pattern all throughout her entire head. And yeah, I'm so excited to show you guys the results because they came out so awesome. Okay, so moving on. So once I get done with each little section, I'm going through every foil and low lighting with 6N, 6T, 6GB, putting a little bit of conditioner to kind of blend it out. And then I'm also lifting the band on the bottom half. So I do this literally throughout her entire head of hair. Like there's not one foil that really, I'm sorry, there's not one strand of hair that doesn't have a foil on it. So here I am again, Kels is helping me. I'm gonna go ahead and put my formula on that little band area. I did 6N, 6T, 6GB because I wanted something that was gonna cool it out, but then I put the GB on there just cause I was afraid that that T was gonna stick too much to the super blonde pieces. So again, did my root, a little bit of conditioner in between, and then I blended right up into it. I Honestly, was having the time of my life doing this color correction. I just love a challenge and I love getting super creative with my foiling. And I also loved how every foil was different. It kind of, I don't know, kept me on my toes. I wish I could record every single foil and like show you guys the different pattern that was done because there was not one foil that was the same as the other. So I don't know, to me, that was super fun. But I'm sure you guys don't want to see 2 full hours of just foiling. And yeah, so this is just the low lighting process, and here you see me again separating that level 10 hair. I honestly have no idea how the colors became what they were because this client had virgin hair before getting this color done. So I really was trying to understand what the stylist did before me, but there was no rhyme or reason, and I can't believe that she let her walk out like this. Like, this was rough, and I'm not one to talk down on other stylists, but this is just like unacceptable to let someone leave like this and then charge them full price. Okay, so it just foiled for 2 hours. Honestly, not bad. I thought it was gonna take way longer because of the banding. So I usually don't see new clients unless I have a last minute opening. And when I saw this client's hair, I was like, I need to get her in my chair ASAP because she has a trip on Friday and she can't be walking around with her hair like that. So I'm excited. I told her, and this is what I usually tell color correction clients, that their very first appointment is always a foundational appointment because you just never know what the hair is gonna do. And even though I'm putting in all this work on her hair right now, I know that it's not gonna look perfect. There's too much banding. I'm not a magician. So I am doing the best that I can, but I told her to get it looking even where I'm happy with it, it's gonna take at least 2 sessions, but today it's foundational and it's gonna be a lot better than what she has right now. So I'm really excited. She is processing and I'm gonna just let her cook a little bit. I'm going through resaturating foils that have dried out, but I'm not mad at the lift and we are gonna hope for the best. So really quickly here, I'm just checking her foils. I did this with every foil in the back and I just went through and resaturated. As you can see, it's drying out. So I'm just putting 30 volume on it and just kicking it. Oh my gosh, sorry if you hear Casey's truck. He just turned it on. But yeah, so I went through and did that with every foil, resaturated just to get maximum lift on it. Okay, so we pulled all her foils out. All the back ones, but I'm gonna just keep it going in this halo section. So it's looking a little cray cray right now, but I'm so happy with her lift. And here are all her foils. Catch! So right now I'm putting some clarifying shampoo on like those low silvery pieces. And I'm gonna let that sit while the rest of her foils process. And I'm just kind of working it in to see if that pigment will remove itself. Goodbye. So we are bootstrapping her with 6N, 6T, 5N. And I'm just kind of tapping out kind of the harsh line that's there. Her lift is amazing. I'm really happy with how even we got everything. And hairbrush has minimal breakage on it, so I'd say so far we're winning. So on the blue band that she has, the blue silverish band, I'm just putting 10 G on it just to fill it a little bit. I feel like her hair is so porous in those areas that it's just holding on to whatever tone it can grab onto. So I'm gonna try to put some gold in there to get it to match kind of the rest of her hair, and that way we can get a really even tone on there. You guys ready?
Ooh,
So still not 100% there. Like I said, color corrections are foundational, but I mean, I'm loving this. Like, the results are amazing. There's still some little pieces in here that aren't perfect, obviously, but I think one more session and we'll get it all out, but honestly,
I'm super, super happy with it. So now, let's curl.
I'm obsessed. I cannot.
Here are her results. I am so incredibly happy with the results. Hope you guys enjoyed this, and don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube.